Want to make handoff easier for developers? Here's how to export assets from Figma in the right format. Whether you're a designer preparing files for a developer, or you're a developer looking to grab assets, I'll walk you through the best practices and common mistakes to avoid. Let's get started. Exporting assets properly ensures developers can implement your design without any issues. We need to follow the right steps to ensure that assets are optimized and easy to work with. Before exporting, it's important to choose the right format based on the project's needs. Here are the most commonly used formats. 1. SVGs. This is best for icons, logos, and illustrations that need to scale without losing their quality. 2. PNGs. They are great for transparent background images. 3. JPEGs. This is best for non-transparent images and photographs. PDFs. This is used for printing or sharing vector design. Now let's jump into Figma and see how to export these assets the right way.
I will introduce you to 5 steps for exporting assets in Figma for developers. Step 1 is selecting assets for exports. Right here in Figma, select the asset you want to export. If it's part of a frame, make sure you are selecting the right layer to avoid missing details. Click on an object, could be an icon or an image, to the right hand properties panel and scroll to the exports section. Here in the export section, click the plus button to add an export setting. Step 2 is choosing the right export settings. Now let us set up the correct export format and size. In the export section, you will see options like scale, 1x, 2x, but you could custom size you wish, and the formats for which you can use. You can choose from SVG, PNG, JPEG, or even PDF. Suffixes can also be added, which is useful for versioning. For example, at 2x for retinal displays. For icons and UI elements, always use SVGs because they are scaly and lightweight. For images, you can go for PNGs or JPEG depending on the transparency needs. Step 3 is understanding advanced export options. Figma also provides advanced options to optimize your assets. We can optimize them in the following ways. 1. Click on this dotted icon here and ignore overlapping layers. This helps remove hidden layers that might interfere with final assets. You can also include ID attributes for SVGs if that option actually shows okay. This adds IDs to SVG elements, which can be useful for animations or custom styling in code. If you're handing off assets to the developer working with SVGs, when you enable the ID attribute in Figma, Figma assigns unique ID values to elements within the SVG. This can be useful for CSS styling, JavaScript manipulation, or referencing elements in animation or script. Developers may need these IDs to target specific SVG parts dynamically in code. For the color profile, you can, for web-based projects, you can stick to sRGB here for high quality exports. The 4th step to exporting design assets in Figma for developers is to export and test on your browser. So once you've set up everything, hit the export and save your file, but you don't just stop there. You always want to test your exported assets by opening them in a browser or a design tool to check if everything looks correct. You also have to check for transparency issues in PNGs. You also want to ensure that SVG files open correctly in your browser. You verify the file sizes to avoid bloated assets. The last and hassle-free step is turning on dead mode. For developers, right here in Figma, I have a section, and once I click on it, the dead mode option here is shown. and then ask me to mark as ready for developers. Or if I want to mark this entire file as ready for developers, I can come over to this, the right hand panel here, and mark as ready for developers. This helps to streamline the design to development process, as it reduces back and forth between designers and developers. This feature also helps developers to inspect CSS, copy code, and download assets directly from the design file. So when you mark design assets as ready for them and open in dev mode, developers can see precise measurements, spacing, and even the styles used for this design. It can also copy the CSS code or the snippets for faster development. They can also export assets easier and download them, reducing this back and forth between designers and developers. By enabling dev mode, you ensure that developers get all the information they need without confusion. Helps to make the workflow smoother and efficient. However, there's some common mistakes that make in assets, and here is how to fix them. One is wrong file format. Use JPEG instead of PNG for transparent assets. And to fix this, you make sure that the format is relevant and is for its particular use. Two is exporting at the wrong scale. You can avoid this by always checking if the assets needs to be 2x for high resolution screens. Three is forgetting to trim extra space. This can be avoided by making sure your assets don't have unnecessary packing. And four, you don't test your SVGs. Make sure you open your SVGs in a browser to check for unwanted clipping or missing elements.
And that's it. Now you know how to export assets from Figma properly, ensuring developers get the right files with that app. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe for more UI UX tips, and let me know in the comments what other export tips you have that you found helpful.